and they were running. Yeah. And not get tired, baby. We just got to wait on the Lord. A lot of us waiting on people to lift us up. But Isaiah 40 said, wait on the Lord, 40:31. We don't want to do that in the house no more, mother. People coming in, they're examining us because we're Christians. Day by day, they're watching us. Just waiting on us to do something wrong, baby. So they can talk about us like a dog.
Oh, yes. My God.
But they don't know. The word of God says, do my prophet no harm. Don't put your hand on God's people. Amen. We all are guilty of something. Let me get my title, bitch, if I want to wipe my feet off too. Because when I didn't know no better, I did that too. Let me tell y'all something. When y'all running out of God's people, you're running out of Jesus himself. Yeah. Mind what you say about that preacher. Yeah. If that preacher hold around, that's that preacher business with God. Because he can always ask God for forgiveness, baby. Yes, yes. And he'll be in heaven and you'll be in hell. Talking about that preacher. What is that preacher now? The preacher ain't perfect. God is.
Yes, sir.
Ain't nobody no holier than Jesus Christ. The man that sits on the throne, on the right hand, on the throne. Ain't nobody no holier than him. We get it twisted.
Yes.
Soon as God ever give us a title, or we get saved, mother, we're better than anybody else. Huh? But ain't nobody exempted from the roof, mama. We're talking about that Bible, mama. We're talking about the Constitution. The thing that make you live right, and make you act right, and make you talk right. Huh? How can you say you're a child of God when you see your neighbor when he speak to him? You got your mind twisted up. You won't even speak to your own neighbor. How you say you're a child of God? Jesus is love, y'all. I learned from the Father to the roof in the temple of the church. God is love. He's not angry. My wife been working on me for years and years. She said, how you going to be a minister? You better get some of that anger out of your soul. You better get your heart right. You better get your business right. When I went to Connecticut, there was a homeboy service by a Christian man. Oh, Lord, we had a good time. Oh, Lord. When I got there, I seen so many people. They said, Pastor, you will have to do your job. You might get weak, but you might get weary. But wait on the Lord. He'll pick you up. We got to stop waiting on people to lift us up. We got to start waiting on the word of God to lift us up. We waiting on people too much. Waiting on people to give us the credit and the knowledge. All we got to do is get in that book, that Holy Bible. That was the instruction. God left for man, that woman, and child. That Bible, the most important thing. It's to live right and act right. Some of us ain't gonna see Jesus. Some of us in here saying, hallelujah, don't even love him. Oh, Lord. There's gonna be a time when daddy come back and bust that sky wide open. Every nigga confess. Oh, Jesus. Some of them going to be hollering and crying, baby. And they'll y'all be the ones that he said, part from me because you didn't know me in the world. They'll y'all be the ones. If you be the ones, you're condemned. And your soul is going to go to hell. And you're going to burn forever and forever.
God, my God.
Yes.
Jesus.
Tell the truth.
When Jesus was working on me, I didn't know what time, what he was doing. But he was working on me Pendleton as a little boy. He used to show me things. But you know, the devil painted a picture for me. He had all these women, all his angels all around me. But I know I wasn't connected to them. Because in my whoring days, in my lying days, I ain't gonna get too many amens off this. But I'm gonna keep it tight and right. But in my whoring days, in my lying days, I always the devil couldn't get me, baby. He had tried so many times. He hit me in the big church and I fell back. But I fell forward right in daddy's arms. So it's going to be blessed.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Lord. I've been there. Hallelujah. I went to the doctor one time and said I had stomach cancer. The doctor wanted to cut on me. I was at Hershey with a cross. They wanted to get me out of here. They wanted to take me out of here, Bishop. Because of somebody else's money. I don't need nobody else's money. The Bible tells me we're all rich in heaven as in earth. Daddy done paid the price when he hung his head on that cross. Y'all should stand up and give him a hand.
Hallelujah.
We sitting right here, mama. We sitting right here, mama. Waiting on people. But those that wait on the Lord, they sell mine up. like eagles. Huh? You know one thing about an eagle, huh? An eagle don't fly with the low bird now. Eagle fly high in the storm. So let me tell y'all something. Don't worry about that storm. God's got it covered because he's going to lift us up. God in the storm. Lord, have mercy. It's going to be tight, but it's going to be right. We waiting. We too many times waiting in the church, mama. Waiting on our family to lift you up. Your family cannot lift you up. Nothing but the word of God can lift you up, mama. They might not let me preach no more here, but I'm going to tell the truth. When I come on strong for my father. He come in the church, burn out the Libra. This is the place for healing. This is the place to give your life to Christ. Anybody here that don't know the Lord? We better get closer and closer. There's signs of wonders he's on his way back. Let's get closer. Get closer, people can get before. We think we got time. We ain't got no time.
Jesus.
Nobody knows when Jesus is going to come back.
Nobody.
If we ain't living the best we can by this right here,
yes,
we're going to bust hell wide open one by one. This is the old covenant and the new covenant for his people.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hell was not designed for God's people.
Yeah.
It was designed for the devil and a third of his angels. So we better get it right. Young ladies, I hope y'all don't take this wrong when I say this. God told me to tell y'all find y'all a husband. Both y'all. Y'all find y'all a husband. Y'all find y'all a husband. Ask the Lord to send y'all a husband. Not a boyfriend and not a pimp, a husband. Y'all find y'all a husband. Y'all find y'all a husband. Y'all find y'all a man that y'all can come to church with on Sundays.
Yeah.
If he don't love the Lord, he don't love you, sugar. No matter how good you look, he got to love the Lord first. I'm here to tell you. Y'all quit wasting time. Time is going over.
Thank you, Jesus.
You tell
him. If I didn't have my wife and God first, I'd be pitiful. I wouldn't have made it to the temple.
Jesus.
I'm going to tell it.
Oh, my God.
God knows the truth.
Yes, he does.
I would have still been out in the world trying to do what I wanted to do.
That's right.
Out of my hours, Burger King have it your way.
Oh.
But when he knocked me down on my back, when the tennis went to hurt, I woke up then.
Jesus.
Yeah.
My God, my God.
As my wife.
Jesus.
Penalty.
Hallelujah.
Penalty.
Hallelujah.
I was the deacon at Love of God Fellowship.
Hallelujah.
Let me show you how the devil do.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to close in a minute, y'all.
Go ahead.
The devil told me to get up and hand my plate and walk out. Praise. And as I was getting up, guess what happened?
Hallelujah.
Brother, as I was getting up, guess what happened?
What happened?
My bag went out. I barely made it to the car.
Jesus.
This thing here, y'all, ain't nothing to play with. This church thing and loving the God and
hallelujah,
his people in this temple, this ain't nothing to play with. Ladies, I was laid up in the bed for 3 days, looking up to the Father. I said, Lord, don't let me pee on myself and don't let me mess this bed up. All I had to do was pee. He had all that stuff away from me.
Hallelujah.
That's a shame when you can look outside and can't get to your car, the one that the Lord bless you with. I couldn't make it to my car.
Amen.
He put me in isolation with him.
Jesus.
Where I had to let him have his way.
Go ahead now.
Don't y'all wait, y'all too young age. Don't do this. Because the isolation he might put on y'all might be worse than me.
Amen.
He had mercy on old Pastor Hemingway. He did. I was a wreck.
Thank you, Jesus. Go ahead.
Out of control.
My God, my God.
Nobody could tell me nothing until I made a penalty.
Amen. My God.
Reverend Henry started, but the devil flew up in me. I ain't gonna lie, I'll tell you. But when I met Pendleton, he said, Pastor, you got to humble. No matter if they treat you wrong, you got to humble yourself.
Go ahead, Minister.
No matter when they hit you with the truth, when they tell the truth, you got to humble yourself.
Humble.
Humble yourself.
My God, my God.
So much going on in the church, and I had a lady call me the other day and say she poured her food out in front of the door of the church. Because somebody pissed her off. Now, come on now, y'all. Jesus don't like that.
No, he doesn't.
When we come in here, We don't come down in here to preach against nobody. We come up here to get Jesus people close to him. This thing is not about me a penitent. It's about saving souls for the kingdom of God. Because the kingdom is closer than what we could imagine. It's just about here.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
I love both of y'all, y'all some pretty ladies, but I ain't gonna tell y'all nothing wrong.
Amen.
See, it took me, I'm 49 now, basically, I'm gonna close in a minute.
Go ahead.
It took me over half of my life to realize what I was doing wrong. Because I had them looks.
Yes.
I ain't gonna lie, because Jesus gave me them looks, because he created me.
Yes,
and I had that money.
Amen.
But when I got old and tired, mother, let me tell you something. When I got old and tired, and when he looked in that mirror, oh Lord, that was, but I didn't wait up till they brought me in on a wheelchair. Someone wait till they get in the wheelchair. What's waiting to come in? They do. I want to wait that
long.
Y'all see how I look now? I never did look this good until I started preaching. I changed. A lot of that sin gone away. Yeah, you change.
My God.
You, how long you been in man? I'm closing. How long you been in man? How long? 16 years. I used to come to man in the early 80s and 90s. And early 80s and 90s. And I was on my way to hell in that moment. And the hotel I went to, Bible was there. I got to tell y'all about the Lord. I said, I'm going to tell you, Bible there. So when you get ready to stand before God, you can't say, well, penitent didn't tell me what to do. Yeah, he did. Minister Hemingway didn't tell me what to do. Yes, he did.
Oh, yes.
There ain't gonna be no whole lot of Lord, I didn't understand. You might have y'all one of them right there. That was my word. This word will never go far, mother.
Amen.
This word will never go far.
Never.
It's the instructions.
Yes, it is.
We all fall short to the glory of God. All of us,
Jesus.
Day by day.
Yes.
But we still got a choice to make, and I'm going to close, Pastor.
Go ahead.
But we still got a choice to make.
Yes.
All we got to do is get on our knees and ask for forgiveness.
Amen.
And repent.
Yes.
God going to forgive you, honey.
Yes, he will.
He forgave me more than one time.
Yes, he will.
He forgave me more than I should have been forgiven. He forgive me.
Yes, he will.
Because, mother, if that devil had his way, y'all would have never seen me.
God.
I would have been in the early grave. See, people don't think about that.
Yes, Lord.
When I was younger, you know what I thought about? I'm going to be young forever.
Yes,
you know,
yeah.
Some of us think that now.
Oh, yeah.
But it don't work that way.
Hey.
Every year is another number.
Oh, my God.
I don't want nobody to go through what I went through in this temple.
Amen.
Before they have to get up, take their position with God. Bishop, you understand?
Go ahead.
I want y'all to start out young doing y'all job, both of y'all ladies.
Amen.
Don't let nothing hold you back.
Amen.
Not in your family. Because when you stand in front of Jesus, both of y'all one and one by one,
hallelujah,
he's not going to mention your mama name, your daddy name. He don't want to know, what did you do?
Yeah.
Did you tell my people right or wrong?
Amen.
Or did you do the best you could for
hallelujah
my people? See, the life we live is not our life, but it belongs to God.
Hallelujah.
He gave it and he take it away.
Oh, yes, yes.
But Bishop, the Bible declares that we live right, we get saved.
Thank you, Jesus.
You know what I mean?
Amen.
Baptized with the Spirit,
uh-huh,
then heaven will be our own.
Yes, it will, man.
Thank you all.
Yes, it will.
But we got to be full of that. And Jesus told me he gonna take care of that baby. Don't you worry about that baby.
Thank you,
he wanna bless y'all with that baby. See, but God is pushing you to do something.
My God.
You know, I see you as an evangelist one day. I just see that. Both of y'all.
Oh, yeah.
I see that.
Yes, sir.
I see you preaching so hard that
woo
things can just change in 1 second.
Hallelujah.
By your power and the love.
Yes,
teacher.
Sir. Thank you, God.
I'm not one of them minister or pastor. I'm like Bishop. I don't want to hold nobody back.
Oh,
I want them to fulfill their destiny, mother.
Yes.
If y'all would have held me back, been in the back sitting down. But that would have been right by God now. Jesus didn't say that.
Right.
But
right,
some of these churches hold back God's people.
Ah,
yeah.
I'd never do that.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'd never do that.
Amen.
long as I live, I'll never do that.
Hallelujah.
If somebody walked through that door, you tell me, minister, let him preach your sermon, you're going to switch me around, I ain't going to be mad.
Amen.
That gives me time to study.
Go ahead, minister.
And prove the word of God.
Ah, my God. Hallelujah.
I'm going to close, y'all.
Amen.
I love each and one of y'all in here from the bottom of my heart to my soul.
Praise God.
I didn't know where I'd be if it wasn't for your husband. God has really done a lot for your husband. He's getting all the glory.
Amen.